Well, first and foremost, thank you for the opportunity to speak to everybody. I wish I could have been there in person, but just didn't work out this time. So looking forward to presenting this. Hopefully you guys had some good presentations earlier. Sounds like maybe some good conversations based on what I caught on the end of the last presentation. So that's exciting. As you said, my name is Michael Van Laken. I'm a restoration ecologist with Western Ecosystems Technology. And I'm very delighted for the opportunity to share some information about rapid ecological assessments today. On behalf of my co-contributors, I will be presenting on the topic of rapid ecological assessments. It's a stepwise strategy to establish, measure, and report metrics of ecosystem health and connecting current case studies within West to restoration efforts on the Middle Rio Grande. There are environmental benefits that can result from establishing and maintaining regionally appropriate sustainable vegetation across different landscapes and ecosystems. Carbon sequestration, improving soil health and soil fertility, providing opportunities for biodiversity uplift, and stormwater retention are just a few examples. Currently, there's actually a lack of verifiable data to measure these environmental co-benefits provided by the restoration and maintenance of regionally appropriate sustainable vegetation at solar facilities. To solve that problem, we have identified some rapid ecological assessment methods to be integrated into the Society for Ecological Restoration's Ecological Recovery Wheel framework as a solution to measure, collect, and report on ecosystem health. Six core attributes of ecosystem health are represented in the outer ring of the recovery wheel, and those stay static, those don't change. But various indicators or sub-attributes for each of those attributes on the outer wheel are identified to be measured to meet goals and objectives of specific projects. In the example shown, you know, there's only a handful of sub-attributes, but there can be as many as 18, 24. It's really variable depending on project and what the goals and objectives are. The rapid assessment methods are used to measure change of each indicator from baseline conditions through the life of the project. The frequency of monitoring depends on project objectives, as determined in coordination with the developer, which is in our case for the solar projects, or in your case, the collaborators and all the stakeholders. Baseline and post-construction data collection can provide empirical data which supports the use of that sustainable restoration strategies. We are currently collecting baseline data at numerous solar projects across the U.S., and we'll be collecting post-construction data in the next several years. These projects can also act as a case study to inform efforts to integrate efficient and affordable assessment methods with the ecological recovery wheel, including efforts in the Middle Rio Grande. The SCR recovery wheel can be a beneficial tool for several reasons. First, it's a way to collect long-term data. Second, the methods to gather data can be rapid and inexpensive, and there's flexibility in the frequency of gathering data. The data can be collected as often as you would like. Finally, the methods for gathering data will be consistent. The data will be collected the same way, no matter the project, location of the project, or period in the project lifespan. Ultimately, these rapid assessments satisfy the need for verifiable data to measure ecosystem health. To implement these rapid assessments, a reference model is first identified prior to fieldwork for all metrics to be evaluated. Public data sets can be used, or field-based reference model data can be collected. Assessments and survey methods and locations are then determined. Some of the assessment methods we are using include quadrat surveys, plot surveys, timed meander surveys, and also soil sampling. Scoring metrics are then established for each project. Baseline and post-construction conditions are evaluated and scored against the reference model. There are numerous sub-attributes that can be chosen to measure changes in ecosystem health. This table includes a subset of some of the options and methods to measure and evaluate. For example, herbaceous cover data can be collected by sampling vegetation within a quadrat. Floral species richness data can be collected by sampling within a quadrat and using a timed meander survey. soil organic matter can also be measured. That's collected by collecting soil samples and then sending those samples to a lab for analysis. Some of these methods collect data that can actually be used to evaluate multiple sub-attributes with the same data. Once the data is collected, the data is evaluated and scored. Here's an example sub-attribute and the chosen scoring metrics. A one-star indicates poor conditions relative to the reference model, while a five-star indicates the project is meeting the reference model conditions. As I mentioned earlier, WES is currently field testing and refining these rapid assessment methods and collecting data at several solar projects across the U.S. While we have baseline data for many projects, we have yet to collect post-construction data. So for that reason, this hypothetical solar project in the Midwest will be used to show assumed changes in ecosystem health, bearing conditions prior to construction against conditions 5 years after construction is completed. In the Midwest, the baseline scenario will often be an agricultural field, and the target would be a short grass prairie or grassland system. And we based our example scoring on what you would expect at a typical site in the Midwest. In the middle Rio Grande, the target might be a post-fire site where the goal is to restore native vegetation. Post-construction conditions will be compared to baseline conditions to assess whether ecosystem health has been maintained or improved as a result of project restoration initiatives. Continued monitoring offers the opportunity to collect data to measure environmental health and the co-benefits local ecosystems may benefit from the restoration and maintenance of sustainable vegetation. For easy communication with project stakeholders, data can also be viewed using an interactive data visualization tool. The tool is designed to display project-specific metrics alongside environmental co-benefits for pre- and post-construction site conditions. Plot-specific comparisons can be viewed for each sub-attribute. This real-time comparison of data allows site managers to identify areas within the project that may require prompt and targeted adaptive vegetation management to improve ecosystem health. Using rapid ecological assessments, such as the globally recognized Recovery Wheel tool, provides the opportunity to collect, evaluate, and report metrics of ecosystem health. When verifiable evidence becomes available, case studies will be available to promote and implement the use of sustainable vegetation with the confidence that ecosystem health can be improved. The baseline data collected at numerous solar facilities thus far provide the opportunity to evaluate benefits of sustainable vegetation and inform adaptive management decisions during operations. The commitment to collect data throughout operations will add to the empirical data measuring environmental co-benefits, such as ecosystem health and biodiversity uplift. This work at solar facilities can act as a case study for applying the ecological recovery wheel to disturbed ecosystems, including the Middle Rio Grande, as well as using rapid ecological assessments to efficiently and affordably monitor baseline and restored conditions for the life of the project. This concludes the presentation on rapid ecological assessments. I would like to thank again my co-contributors and also the individuals involved with the MRG project. I appreciate the opportunity to provide this presentation at the Science Symposium.